Hello children, myself Rupa Chemistry, okay, Rupa Kuntala, and I am a chemistry faculty in Sri Chaitanya Junior College in residential campuses in Hyderabad. So today I am going to discuss the first chapter, atomic structure. But first of all, let me tell you that in this chapter, atomic structure, I am not going to discuss any the big concept which is useful for competitive examination. Here, this video is meant for only plus one and plus two studies. Means to just complete your intermediate level, plus one, plus two, you have to write the answers for the given questions in limited points. Okay, limited points. So without wasting the time and the point to the answer type of questions we are going to discuss. So here the very first topic in plus one intermediate first year, the chapter name is atomic structure, where you deal the structure of a atom. So in previous classes, other videos, we have learned that the atom is made up of subatomic particles. So in that we learn that the arrangement of these fundamental particles like protons, neutrons and electrons in the atom, that different models were proposed by different people. Such are called as atomic models. The very first model was constructed by J.J. Thomson, according to which the atom must be spherical. The atom must be spherical. Okay, which we have learned. Then, in that spherical atom, J.J. Thomson told that the atom will have a radius of Van Angstrom, and in which the positive charge is uniformly spread like the red color pulpy material, which is spread in the watermelon, and to balance the positive protons charge, the electrons embedded in that spherical pulpy mass in the form of seeds with a negative charge. So according to Thomson, which explains only electrical neutrality and gave the great idea that atom is a spherical. Then after that, we learn that Rutherford, scientist, did an alpha ray scattering experiment and proposed his nuclear model, in which we learn that the atom contained a dense spherical nucleus. Okay, dense means here we all know that the atom contained the subatomic particles, electron which are negative, protons which are positive, and the neutron which are no charge, neutral. So we generally know that the mass of the atom is the sum of protons and neutrons, because when you compare the mass of the electron, is about 10,000 times lesser than each proton and each neutron. So in the calculation of atomic mass, we never calculate, consider the electron. So the total mass of the atom is because of protons and neutron. And since total mass is protons and neutron, means the total density is present in the nucleus. So according to Rutherford, he proved that by alpha ray scattering experiment, the atom at the center contains the spherical nucleus, which is dense, means its all mass is located, and which is totally positive charge. Why? Because the total mass means protons which are positive and neutrons which are neutral. So the total mass is present. Hence this spherical mass is known as a dense nucleus, and because of positive protons, the spherical nucleus will be positive in a charge. So in the atom, we have arranged the protons and neutrons according to Rutherford. Then Rutherford said that around this around this nucleus, which is spherical, the electrons are revolving in the given circular path, which are called as orbits. But Rutherford theory could not explain why atoms give line spectra. Because when electron like a very tiny particle, just now we came to know that the each electron mass is about 10,000 times lesser than each proton and each neutron. Means compared to protons, the mass of the electron is very, very small, negligible. But at the same time, the charge of the electron is equal to charge of proton. The whatever charge is present on the proton, the same charge is present but with opposite charge, with opposite sign. Means protons are positive and electrons are negative. So according to electrodynamics means the movement of charges. According to electrodynamics, whenever a tiniest particle, charged particle, revolves around the opposite charge, then continuously it will be attracted by nucleus and must fall into the nucleus. If it's so, atom will blast. But atoms are stable. So Rutherford theory could not explain this. In the same time, when this electron is in continuous motion around this nucleus, it must tire and releases energy. And the released energy, when it is observed through the prism, then the splitting of the different wavelengths of that emitted light is observed. And this splitting of different radiations, when these are observed on the photographic film, we get a spectrum. It is called a spectrum or electromagnetic spectrum, on which the different wavelengths of radiations which are emitted by the moving electron are arranged. So the different radiations in increasing order of their wavelengths are arranged. So this arrangement is called as a spectrum. So according to Rutherford, when the electron is continuously moving around the nucleus, it has to lose electron continuously and the spectrum must be continuous. Means each radiation will have what? Wavelengths. So all the wavelengths of emitted light must be what? Close to each other. So the emitted light, which is observed as spectral lines in the spectrum, they must be close to each other. Means all must appear as a band. Okay? Band continuous to each other. Means the first one will merge with the second. Second will merge with the third. Third will merge with the fourth. Like that, between the spectral lines, there will be no space. But practically what happened? The atoms, when their spectrum is observed, means when the electrons are absorbing or emitting energy, it is observed that the spectrum contains not continuous, not band. It contains well separated spectral lines. So here, each line indicates emitted light, and which are arranged in the increasing order of their wavelengths. Okay, if it is emitted light is taken as spectrum, so it is called as emission spectrum. Or if it is during absorption of light by light or energy by this electron is taken spectrum, then which is called as absorption spectrum. So which is having the largest spaced spectral lines, which is called as discontinuous line spectrum. So Rutherford could not explain the line spectrum or discontinuous spectrum of atom. So now here in Bohr's model, this model according to Bohr, which is applicable to, first of all listen, it is applicable to any species having one electron. Means hydrogen atomic number is 1, means which contain one electron. Like that, any species having single electron, okay, like helium, we know that the atomic number of helium is 2, means 2 electrons. So when it will become one electron, if it is losing one electron, helium plus cation. Like that, lithium, atomic number 3, means 3 electrons. So if it is losing 2 electrons, lithium plus 2. So 2 electrons are lost, 1 electron is left. And next, if you take beryllium, beryllium whose atomic number is 4. 4 means it is having the 4 electrons. But this theory is not applicable to the 4 electrons. So therefore, we have to make it to 1 electron, which is applicable, limited to Bohr's theory. So remove 3 electrons, beryllium plus 3, cation. So now, these species contain what? 1 electron. So it is what? The merit of Bohr's theory, at the same time, the drawback, or you can say limit. It is permitting only for 1 electron species. So this theory applicable to any atom or ion which contain only 1 electron. So these. So according to Bohr's theory, what is that explained? As said by Rutherford, the atom contain the spherical nucleus where all the positive charge and all the mass is present. And around this nucleus, electrons are revolving. Since the nucleus is spherical, the path around the nucleus will be spherical. And in this spherical path, the electron is revolving. So here, the one additional point which is explained here is that in the atom around the nucleus, there are infinite number of orbits. Means, don't think that around the nucleus only one orbit is present. There are how many orbits are present? Infinite number of orbits. And each orbit is named by the principal quantum number, which is given by small n. And here, which are numbered from the nucleus to outside. So very closest one is 1, next 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. The last one is infinite, n equal to infinite. So around the nucleus, there are infinite number of circular parts which are designated by 1, 2, 3, 4 up to infinity or alphabets K, L, M, N, O, P, etc. And here, the electrons are revolving around the nucleus in the given any of the orbits. And Bohr calculated that whenever the electron is revolving around the nucleus in the given orbit, it will have a definite velocity. Okay? In the given orbit, the electron revolves with a definite velocity. Means, the Bohr has proposed one formula to calculate the velocity of an electron. And as long as electron revolves in the given orbit, its energy, the energy of electron remains constant. Means, if the electron present in the first orbit, its energy will be equal to first orbit. Or, if any electron revolves in the second orbit, its energy is equal to second orbit. Or if it is third orbit, equal to third orbit. Means, as long as electron present in the given orbit, it is having a constant energy. But, if the electron is shifting from one orbit to another, say, here, the electron present in the given orbit, say this orbit is fifth one. So, its energy is equal to fifth orbit energy. If it is going to the lower orbit, that is E4, then it emits energy. So, in this case, if the electron is going from high energy level to low energy level, then it emits energy, and the emitted energy, if it is studied through the prism or spectrometer, then we see that an emission spectrum is obtained, which contain the lines which look brighter lines against a dark background. Since the light is emitted, okay, it is called as emission spectrum. Or From this fifth orbit, if the electron is shifted to sixth orbit, then it has to gain some energy, because as n value increases, the energy of orbit increases, and the energy of electron equal to energy of orbit means when the electron is going from low energy to high energy, it has to gain some energy. So that is equal to the difference between the way from electron is shifting. So here E5 to E6, so it has to gain energy, because E5 is lower energy, E6 is higher energy. So in this case, when the electron is shifting from 5th orbit to 6th orbit, it has to gain energy. That is the difference between the 6th orbit and 7th orbit, where 6th is high energy and 5th is low energy, and which can be given as simply delta E, means change of energy between the two energy levels where the electron is getting change. It's a position. It is called as electronic transition. So it is shifting from low energy to high energy, it has to gain energy. That is equal to high energy level minus low energy level. So this energy which is absorbed, or if it is released, in the case of if the electron is shifting from high energy to low energy, then that energy will be absorbed or emitted in the form of packet. In the form of packet, which is called as photon according to Einstein, or quanta according to Max Planck theory. So that packet of energy is called h nu. So whenever an electron is shifting from one orbit to another orbit, it is going to lower orbit, emits energy. It is going to higher orbit, absorbs energy. And that energy change will be in the form of a photon. And whatever it is emitted or absorbed, that will appear as spectral lines in the spectrum of the atom. So here on this board, okay, I have drawn some spectrum of hydrogen spectrum. So here, see, n equal to 1 means first orbit. It is first orbit, which is ground state of a hydrogen atom, means after the nucleus, you have first orbit. This is first orbit. Next, as you move outside from nucleus to outside, the n value gradually increases and the energy increases. So n1 lesser than 2, 2 lesser than 3, 3 lesser than 4. Like that, here around the nucleus, how many infinite number of orbits are present? So this is what infinite orbit, which is last orbit. So here, when this hydrogen gas is heated by maybe heating or electric discharge, then what happens in the sample of hydrogen gas? Don't think that there is only one hydrogen molecule. It will have millions of hydrogen molecules. And first thing, what happens when the hydrogen gas is heated up or electrically discharged? Then first happening is what? The H2 molecule dissociates into H atoms. So if it is you are having the millions of H2 molecules, so how much atoms you get? Double millions of hydrogen atoms. And each atom contains one electron. So from that atom, which we believe that the electron present in first orbit. But we don't know whether it is present in first orbit or second orbit. Because according to Bohr's theory, around the nucleus, there are infinite number of orbits are present. The electron can be present in any of the orbit. And wherever it is present, the electron energy is equal to those orbits, and as long as electron revolves in the given orbit, its energy remains constant. Means neither lose energy nor gain energy. But if electron shifting, transition from higher to lower, lower to higher, the energy changes takes place in the form of a quanta, and that will appear as the spectral lines. So in this spectrum, you see that series of lines. See here, the first series UV region, which is discovered by Lyman scientist, then visible series, Balmer scientist, then all these four, IR, means infrared. This near IR means close to the visible. Mid IR means between the near and far. So here, these four, Passion, Brackett, Pfund and Humphrey, this all belongs to the infrared. For intermediate level, we just discussed five series. So here three light regions are there: ultraviolet, visible light and infrared. So here see, why these are called series? Because the series contain many lines. Series contain many lines. So the hydrogen atom, in hydrogen atom, the electron may present in first orbit or second orbit anywhere. If it is on heating, absorbs energy and goes to the energy level. So from there, if it is coming back to the ground state, emits a lot of energy which is equal to the energy of ultraviolet region, which appears as red in color. Okay, or from anywhere, if the electron of the hydrogen atom is relaxing, excited electron coming down by releasing energy, so it de-excites or relaxes. So if it is coming to the second orbit, the energy released will be lesser than ultraviolet, which falls in the wavelength of visible region, and the visible will contain what VIBGR: violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. So here I have shown something. Here the very first line in any series, the very first line. First line means the very first line, shortest line, which is from the next higher orbit. So this alpha line, first orbit. So the shortest line is, it is what? First line. The first line observed is red color. Okay. The next, some bluish green, second line. Next, which is blue, then ultraviolet. Okay. So these four, red, bluish green, and this violet, and this blue, this is blue, and violet. Four, the series lines were first discovered by Balmer. Means before this ultraviolet also, and infrared also, the visible region was first identified by Balmer. And after that, there are these remaining infrared series were discovered. So from anywhere, if the electron, from any higher energy, if it is electron coming to the second orbit, it emits the energies or radiations belong to the visible region. Such is called as visible series. Then it is up to third, is called as a passion series, falls in the red color, infrared. Like that, fourth, fifth, sixth. Okay, so here the each transition, the each line indicates that when, see here, in each series the line is pointing downwards, means the light is, the spectral line is coming down, means the light is emitted. So here the whatever spectrum we are discussing, that is emissions.